fellow trainers, to another episode of The Pondcast. Today's episode, Spookymon. I'm your host, the dreadful Draco. Joining me today is Creepy Chase and Ghoulish Glen.
What is cracking?
Hello.
So as I stated, this episode is all about spooky Pokemon in the spirit of Halloween. Those of you who celebrate it, those who don't, who just enjoy the trick-or-treating, everybody's always welcome here. We're going to be going over our most favorite Pokemon and why, and our least favorite spooky Pokemon and why. And so I'm going to start by baton passing this one right over to Glen. How about you give us a go?
All right. Okay, so I actually had a kind of hard time to choose between for my favorite ones, but I had to do with, like, I think my first pick, because I think so for my favorite spoopy Pokemon, it's actually going to be Phantom. I don't know why, like, when I first saw this guy in when he appeared, was it Gen 6, I was like, man, that thing is so adorable. Like, it's like a little ghost will-o-wisp thing with like a wooden head, you know, or a tree head, you know. And then you know, you read its Pokedex entry, and this is the Sword and Shield entry, but after a lost child perished in the forest, their spirit possessed a tree stump, causing the spirit's rebirth as this Pokemon. So it's like, lost kids in the woods, didn't make it out, they became a Pokemon. It's like you have your own little child with you when you catch one. In a scary way, I mean, like... I do like its shiny form as well, because it does look like a withered stump, or like an ashen stump head, and then the red like leaves kind of make it seem like it's fall. So, you know, I think it kind of matches the theme with the whole Halloween thing as well, because, you know, Halloween does fall around autumn fall ish time depending on where you live. So yeah, there's that. And then for my least favorite one, this one it was to the point where, like, I totally forgot about this Pokemon. So my choice is actually Cursola. I like the regional variant for Corsola, but its evolution form, not really. Like, I don't know what you're trying to tell me. Galarian Cursola, Corsola was already technically dead coral, and Cursola, its evolved form, is like more dead coral with a face. I mean, I don't know what else to think about this Pokemon, except for it's like, it's kind of lazy. Not to mention that it's not that great in the battle scene compared to its previous form as well. Like, I think most people would still run the Galarian Corsola over the Cursola. God, their names are too similar too. That's another thing. Their names are way too damn similar. Corsola, Cursola. Like, I swear, like, I could even just say their names, like, without a thought in my mind, and I'd still be saying the same word.
Fair point. Corsola. Yeah, now you got me doing it. Thanks. But yeah, no, I run the unevolved version because the evolved version doesn't give me what I need out of it.
Annoying.
Yeah. Well, for battles at least, you know, you really run a weakness policy Cursola. Mm. So there's not really much in the way of battle potential there, at least from my perspective.
Well, speaking of your perspective, what about you? What's your favorite and your least favorite spooky based Pokemon?
Sorry, I came unprepared and Glen stole my favorite Pokemon.
I'm sorry.
Okay, so what?
I can change it.
I got a backup. So, for my favorite Pokemon that I had to change, thanks, Glen. I changed my favorite to Palossand because he's definitely up there for my top five favorite ghost type. But, you know, looking for spoopy Pokemon, I also had a look at the Dex entries, and Palossand's reads as follows. It says, Palossand is known as the Beach Nightmare. It pulls its prey down into the sand by controlling the sand itself, and then it sucks out their souls. Now, if that's not scary, I don't know what is. And its design and its shiny are just, oh, chef's kiss good.
Oh yeah, it's black sand, yeah, for the shiny.
Yeah, yeah, turning you into a piece of juicy fruit.
I mean, jeez. You know what? If I'm gonna get crushed, it might as well be at the beach while I'm having fun.
So what's your least favorite?
My least favorite is Pumpkaboo. Well, Pumpkaboo and Gourgeist.
Oh, we fight.
You know, listen here, don't make get the gloves out. No, it's just I'm not really a big fan of it because I feel like, or at least for myself personally, it gets very much overlooked thanks to Phantom and Trevenant, because I feel like design. design-wise, in my opinion, they look better, and I feel like they are more popular, so that kind of leaves Pumpkaboo and Gourgais behind, and realistically, their designs are fairly lackluster, although they do have that thing going on for them where they have the different sizes. But yeah, in all honesty, I don't really have much good to say about the Pumpkaboo and Gourgais line.
I want you to know I'm making faces at you right now. You can't see it, but I'm making faces at you right now. Here's where I'm going to jump in with mine. You want to take a wild guess at what my favorite Pokemon is?
I think it's Spooktacular. Is it Gourgais?
And it's ironically, it is kind of for the same reasons that you don't like it. I do like the fact that it comes in different sizes and that each size has its own set of stats, but I think the one thing that really draws me to this particular mon is the signature move that it has. It has Trick or Treat. Woo, creative. Yes, I know. But the ability to smack a ghost typing on any Pokemon on the field is interesting to me because it can either make a Pokemon insanely resistant, like, say, Obstagoon, which you get a normal dark ghost typing, makes it immune to four different things. Or you can crack open someone's defense by now tacking on an additional set of weaknesses to a Pokemon, or even doubling those weaknesses to a Pokemon. So let's say Psychic Ghost type is going to take four times the damage to Dark attacks now. So that alone just kind of gives me the whole, I love this thing. And I'm not going to read the entry text for this because it has four different entry texts for Sword and Shield. Needless to say that it's either going to pretend to be a kid or an adult depending on the size and then just drag somebody to the afterlife. That is basically the Cliff Notes version of the Dex entries for these guys.
That's pretty literally Trick or Treat.
Plus the shiny. The shiny on this one is really solid.
Oh, it's not bad. That's true.
She literally goes to the salon and has her hair dyed.
My least favorite now, and I have to kind of put this one with all of the similar type mon, Bucephalon. I can't. I just can't. I have this issue with the Ultra Beast and Bucephalon being a fire ghost type. The way it looks, I just cannot get behind it. Its design as a whole is just a complete and total turn off to me. Like, I don't even know if I have one in my living decks, but yeah.
I mean, you know, it is it's a very busy design.
I can agree. A lot of colors.
It looks like a Jackson Pollock, okay? On steroids.
I mean, why is that so accurate?
Because it's a Jackson Pollock? I don't know. It
does have a clown multi.
Like, well, it looks like Jackson Pollock did the coloring and Andy Warhol put the thing together alongside with Duchamp.
Oh gosh, that is a frightful combination.
Yeah,
and
right?
Yes, pun very much intended.
If you actually take ghost Pokemon as a whole and just start looking through the actual dex entries, they are beyond disturbing. All of them, from Haunter all the way to Dreepy. They're all kind of really just in a messed up place.
The ones that freak me out are probably Dreepy and Litwick.
Really?
Yeah.
So I'm throwing this one out there, and I know it's kind of random and sudden, but honorable mention, what Pokemon in the spooky category of ghosts would be a follow-up for you in the best category? One that should deserve an honorable mention.
So this basically the mod I was talking about earlier, how like I couldn't decide. So this Pokemon actually has like some regional sentimental value to me, and it's going to be Alolan Marowak, because the region it did debut in was the Alola region, and me being from Hawaii, it's kind of cool, like especially since they took it out of the whole like Night Marcher motif kind of thing as well, for what it was based off of. And like as a kid, like I always wanted a Marowak too, like in the older generation games, and now the fact that it has like an Alolan form based off of a region where I live, it's like, yes, so like perfect. Like, you know, that would have been another thing to talk about too.
That's actually kind of awesome. What about you, Chase?
I think I'd have to go with Spectria. That similar to Glen, in the sense that it holds a bit of sentimental value. But I'm using that sort of in the looser sense because I don't quite know how to describe it. But I grew up around horses, and to have a sort of like a horsey type Pokemon that that's designed really speaks to me, a typing that I'm very passionate about. And Spectra ticks all those boxes.
Very cool, very cool.
I thought you were going to say Phantom for your second. Like, wow. Honestly, I was like, oh no, here it comes. Here it comes.
just put another knife in my back. Just
for me, if I didn't mention this, I think my wife would file for divorce. But it would have to be Mimikyu. It's a Pokemon that is dear to actually the both of us. It's she actually has a I got her a Scarecrow Mimikyu. I'll see if I can get a picture post on here. But it's was one of her favorite Pokemon next to Sylveon. This one it's a Pokemon that we both have an affinity for. I actually like the design aspects of it. She loves the fact that it's a ghost fairy type. And honestly, it's one of the few things that we both share, because she, until we started seeing each other, she wasn't really ever into Pokemon. Then I kind of got her hooked into Pokemon, and this is like her second or her third most favorite Pokemon. So for me, it's a sentimental thing.
You know what? I'm very partial to a bit of Mimikyu. Design wise, definitely one of the, in my opinion, one of the most uniquely designed Pikachu clones.
True.
By being a legit Pikachu clone and not at the same time.
Who knew? The secret sauce was just to dress up like Pikachu.
Right, something completely different.
And then, like, just to add on to that too, it's another Pokemon that debuted in the Alola region, so it's like, oh, sweet, another, like, a cool, like, more iconic Pokemon debuted from Alola, so that's pretty cool for me.
Speaking of Mimikyu, what I'd enjoy seeing is more sort of costume variants for it.
Mm.
So maybe just specifically starters or event, or maybe even specifically event Mimikyu, that maybe one that dresses like a Marshadow.
Mm. Okay. Game Freak, take this, guys. Take Chase's ideas, please. You guys would make money.
You would think that. I mean, the problem with is that the lore behind it, they've always pushed was it was always angry against Pikachu. So we don't really know what Mimikyu actually looks like, other than the fact that it looks like Pikachu-esque. But I think you're onto something, where if they were to turn around and give it its give it alternate costumes based on other Mon.
I mean, they could even do them as regional variants, and it would fit pretty well. Just not have Pikachu in that region, and then the Mimikyu would maybe latch onto something else.
I like that idea.
It's gonna be hard to, like, not have a Pikachu in a region nowadays, though, huh? Nowadays, I mean,
not too loudly.
Meowth is the new mascot.
All right. Well, that about sums up our spooky episode today, trainers. So hopefully you guys had as much fun with joining us and talking about our spooky Pokemon. And go ahead, feel free to leave your comments on your favorite spooky Pokemon and your least favorite spooky Pokemon. We'd love to hear from all of you. Thank you so much for joining us. Have a happy Halloween, a safe Samhain, and most importantly, enjoy your holidays. Thank you very much. Bye.
Cheers.
Ha 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 ha